God of all peoples, you are the true light, illumining everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life. And you love us even when we are disobedient. And you sustain us with your Holy Spirit. And I want to share with you, there are several things that as we talked that you shared about your love for each other and how you see each other. And I wanted to share some of those comments. In the scripture that we read from 1 Corinthians 13, I appreciated the way in which Mary and Catherine read that. Just, they filled it with the love that is there, as Paul writes. But for you, three words came out very quickly as we met. Patience, forgiveness, and kindness. That be a foundation in your relationship, not just with each other, but as you care for everyone else around you, both friends and strangers. And then Liz, this is what you said about Alex. Alex is the embodiment of patience, humility, and being a comfort. And then Alex, this is what you said about Liz. You shared this. You said Liz is forgiving, comforting, and nurturing. And I appreciate hearing the power of those words. Because what those words involve is when we are together, we're not always at our best sometimes. You know, sometimes we're facing some challenges and we need the other person to pick us up. And we need to know that another person will be there and will pick us up and will carry us. And part of our marriage is knowing those moments where we share each other's strength. There are times where we're going to maybe be listening more, maybe times where we're speaking more. But as we do so, we live in this wonderful harmony of living out God's love, of completing that process of growing in Christ and growing in our marriage. We know that in everything, we have a chance to help the other grow, even as we grow ourselves, to commit ourselves to being the best, but also providing that opportunity for each person. For Alex, for Liz to be her best, and Liz for Alex to be his best, and we give each other that opportunity. You also said this too, which I thought was really neat. You said one of the great gifts of getting to know each other and falling in love is that you have seen different facets of God's character in each other. And that has been an opportunity for you to appreciate that and name it, but also to grow in it as well. And so to continue to do so. Continue to make that commitment in your lives, to have that kind of focus and that love. And you also said this. You said, we want to reflect Christ's love through our life. And what Jesus always has done within our lives is allowed us to love in the midst of the everyday. Not just in the special moments, but in every moment. And allow every moment then to become special as we share that love, both in our family, with our friends, in our care for the world, and in our love as husband and wife. And then you also said this. You said that sharpening each other's character, how God uses each other to sharpen each other's character. And then you said this. You said 1 Corinthians 13 are not just words, but a calling to live out the love of Christ in our marriage and our daily life. And so I would just encourage you, as you prepare to say your vows to each other, is to remember those words of Paul. Reread them. Memorize them if you haven't heard anything said. But also, just live them. Just live them with each other and with those around you. And as you do so, you will honor God. You will live out his love, and you will be a shining light of God's grace to everyone around you. May God bless you in your marriage, and may God bless you in your love for each other. Amen. I invite your wedding party to join me up front. We gather in this space for our vows. This is my solemn vow. In the name of God, I, Elizabeth, take you, Alexander, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall. This is my son. I appreciate that moment because Mitchell has been clear. He has had these rings for a long time. And now he can relax because he's done that for a while. And now these rings, which everyone will see much better once they are on the appropriate fingers, are the symbols that you have chosen for yourselves and for the world to say that you are husband and wife, that you are surrounding yourself in the endless love of God that neither has and no beginning nor end, but is always with us. And so now, Elizabeth, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, and with all that I am, and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Alexander, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow. And with all that I am, and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And now to all who have gathered this day, bear witness to the love of God in this world, so that those whom love is a stranger will find in you most generous friends. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and always. Amen. Now, Alex and Liz, I invite you to seal this marriage with your kiss. I like how you make lost notes before you introduce your kiss. So now I'm going to turn that I introduce you for the very first time. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Alexander Carter.
I can't take my eyes off of you. 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 I can't take my eyes. So it is, just like you say.
One more time, nice and loud, so the people next door can hear you. And since we have this gorgeous cake sitting in front of everybody, we're going to go right into our cake cutting, so keep those cameras ready. Whenever you're ready, Mr. and Mrs. Carter. Thank you. crew without getting any audio. And one more time, put them together out there for Mr. and Mrs. Carter.
With a stranger, you're all I'm thinking of. I pray the